Good morning all. In the previous class we have learned different types of houses and then different types of roofs we learn. Okay, today I give some question answers in this lesson. We learn in this that question answers. First one, fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks. Bricks, cement, iron and steel are used to build these houses. Bricks, cement, iron and steel are used to build dash houses, pakka houses. These materials are used to build a pakka houses. Spell the word pakka houses. P-U-C-C-A. Pakka houses. Once again, bricks, cement, iron and steel are used to build dash houses, pakka houses. Spell the word pakka. P-U-C-C-A. Pakka houses. Next one. And dash is a housing unit that occupies only part of a building. And dash is a housing unit that occupies only a part of a building. What is this? An apartment. An apartment is a housing unit that occupies only part of a building. It's a multi-story building. Spell the word apartment. A P A R T M E N T. Apartment. Once again, spell the word apartment. A P A R T M E N T. Apartment. An apartment is a housing unit that occupies only a part of a building. Only a part of a building. Next one. A dash is a house having a single story. A dash is a house having a single story. Which house is have a single story? A bungalow. Bungalow is having is a house having a single story. Spell the word bungalow. B U N G A L O W. Bungalow. A bungalow is a house having a single story. Spell the word bungalow. B U N G A L O W. Bungalow. Once again, spell the word bungalow. B U N G A L O W. Bungalow. And then next one. Mud, wood, straw, stones, and bamboo are used to make dash type of houses. Mud, wood, straw, stones and bamboo are used to make dash type of houses. Used to make kacha houses. Spell the word kacha. K-U-T-C-H-A. Kacha houses. Mud, wood, straw, stones and bamboo are used to make kacha houses. Spell the word kacha. K-U-T-C-H-A. Kacha. Once again, spell the word kacha. K-U-T-C-H-A. Kacha houses. And the next one. A dash is an example of a kacha houses. A dash is an example of a kacha houses. A hut is an example of a kacha houses. A hut is an example of a kacha houses. Spell the word hut. H-U-T. Once again, spell the word hut. H-U-T. Hut means what? Kudusu veedu. A hut is an example of a kacha houses. And the next one. A tent is made of dash. A tent is made of dash. A tent is made of canvas. A tent is made of what? Canvas. C-A-N-V-A-S. Canvas. A tent is made of canvas. Once again, spell the word canvas. C-A-N-V-A-S. Canvas. And then next one. Houseboats are found in dash and dash. Houseboats are found in Jammu and Kashmir. Houseboats are found in dash and dash. Where that houseboats are found? Jammu and Kashmir. Spell the word Jammu. J-A-M-M-U. Jammu and Kashmir. K-A-S-H-M-I-R. Kashmir. Houseboats are found in dash and dash. house boats are found in Jammu and Kashmir. Once again, spell the word Jammu. J A M M U. Jammu and Kashmir. Spell the word Kashmir. K A S H M I R. Kashmir. Next one. A clean house helps us to stay dash. A clean house helps us to stay dash. Healthy. A clean house helps us to stay healthy. Spell the word healthy. H E A L T H Y. Healthy. Once again, spell the word healthy. H E A L T H Y. Healthy. And then next question. We should keep our house dash and dash. We should keep our house neat and clean. Spell the word neat. N E A T. Neat and tidy or clean. Anything you have write. Tidy, neat and otherwise clean you have write. Okay, we should keep our house neat and clean. We should keep our house neat and clean. Spell the word neat. N E A T. Neat. Clean. C L E A N. Clean. And then next question is, a dash is the most important part of a house. A dash is the most important part of a house. Which one is the important part of a house? A roof is the important part of a house. Spell the word roof. R O O F. A roof is the important part of a house. Once again I explain. Fill in the blanks. Listen. Bricks, cement, iron and steel are used to build dash houses. Pakka houses. Spell the word pakka. P U C C A. Pakka houses. And then and dash is a housing unit that occupies only a part of a building. An apartment. An apartment is a housing unit that occupies only a part of a building. An apartment is a multi-story building. Okay. So spell the word apartment. A P A R T M E N T. Apartment. Once again spell the word apartment. A P A R T M E N T. Apartment. And then next question. A dash is a house having a single story. A dash is a house having a single story. A bungalow is a house having a single story. Spell the word bungalow. B U N G A L O W. Bungalow. Once again spell the word bungalow. B U N G A L O W. Bungalow is a housing house having a single story. And then next question. Mud, wood, straw, stones and bamboo are used to make dash type of houses. These materials are used to make a kachcha houses. Okay, these materials are used to make a kachcha houses. That mud, wood, straw, stones, idella vechi enna da panna mudiyum kachcha houses. Okay, they are build kachcha houses. Spell the word kachcha. K U T C H A. Kachcha houses. K U T C H A. Kachcha houses. Next question. A dash is an example of a kachcha houses. A dash is an example of a kachcha houses. A hut is an example of a kachcha houses. Okay, spell the word hut. H U T. Hut. Okay, spell the word hut. H U T. The next one. A tent is made of dash. A tent is made of canvas. A tent is made of canvas. Spell the word canvas. C A N V A S. Canvas. And the next question. Houseboats are found in dash and dash. Houseboats are found in Jammu and Kashmir. Houseboats are found in Jammu and Kashmir. Spell the word Jammu. J A M M U. Jammu and Kashmir. K A S H M I R. Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir. Next question. A clean house helps us to stay healthy. A clean house helps us to stay healthy. Spell the word healthy. H E A L T H Y. Healthy. Spell the word healthy. H E A L T H Y. Healthy. And the next one. We should keep our house dash and dash. We should keep our house neat and clean. We should keep our house neat and clean. Spell the word neat. N E A T. Neat and clean. C L E A N. Clean. Once again, spell the word neat and clean. N N E A T. Neat. C L E A N. Clean. Neat and clean. Next one. A dash is the most important part of a roof. Important part of a house. A dash is the most important part of a house. A roof is the most important part of a house. Spell the word roof. R O O F. Roof. Spell the word roof. R O O F. Can you clear this fill in the blanks, ma'am? Yes. Next we learn. Answer the following. Some short answers now learn. First one. What are huts made up of? What are huts made up of? என்ன மெட்டீரியல்லாம் வச்சு ஹட்ஸ் மேக் பண்ணுறோம்? பேம்பு, வுட்டு, சாண்டு, ஸ்டோனு, மட்டு. தீஸ் மெட்டீரியல்ஸ் ஆர் யூஸ் டு மேக் அ ஹட்ஸ். ஹட்ஸ் ஆர் மேட் அப் ஆஃப், ஓகே, ஹட்ஸ் ஆர் மேட் அப் ஆஃப் மட், பேம்பு, வுட், ஸ்ட்ரா அண்ட் ஸ்டோன்ஸ். ஓகே, வாட் ஆர் ஹட்ஸ் மேட் அப் ஆஃப்? ஹட்ஸ் ஆர் மேட் அப் ஆஃப் மட், பேம்பு. மட்டுன்னு என்னது? மண். அண்ட் தென் பேம்பு, மூங்கில், வுட்டு, மரத்தோட கட்டைகள், அப்புறம் வைக்கோல், அந்த ஓலை, இதெல்லாம் வச்சு தான் இந்த ஹட்டு மேக் பண்ணுறோம். ஸ்ட்ரா அண்ட் ஸ்டோன்ஸ். சம் ஸ்டோன்ஸ் ஆர் தோ ஆல்சோ தே ஆர் ஆல் யூஸ் டு பில்டு. ஹட்ஸ் ஆர் மேட் அப் ஆஃப் மட், பேம்பு, வுட், ஸ்ட்ரா அண்ட் ஸ்டோன்ஸ். ஸ்ட்ரா அண்ட் ஸ்டோன்ஸ். அண்ட் தென் நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், வாட் ஆர் பங்களாஸ்? Already know what are bungalows. A bungalow is a house having a single story. Okay, a bungalow is a house having a single story and many rooms in this bungalow, and then small garden also in front of it. May that garden or may not the garden in front of the bungalow. Okay, what are bungalows? A bungalow is a house having a single story. அங்கே என்னது? ஒரு சிங்கிள் ஸ்டோரி தான் இருக்கும். ஏ பங்களா இஸ் அ ஹவுஸ் ஹேவிங் அ சிங்கிள் ஸ்டோரி. ஏ பங்களா கேன் ஹாவ் மெனி ரூம்ஸ். ஆனால் அதுக்குள்ளே என்ன இருக்கலாம்? நிறையா ரூம்ஸ் இருக்குது. அதே போல் ஸ்மாலாக ஒரு கார்டனும் இருக்கும். ஏ பங்களா இஸ் அ ஹவுஸ் ஹேவிங் எ சிங்கிள் ஸ்டோரி. ஏ பங்களா கேன் ஹாவ் மெனி ரூம்ஸ். ஏ பங்களா கேன் ஹாவ் மெனி ரூம்ஸ் அண்ட் அ ஸ்மால் கார்டன். ஏ பங்களா கேன் ஹாவ் மெனி ரூம்ஸ் அண்ட் அ small garden. Once again I explain these two questions. What are huts made up of? What are huts made up of? Huts are made up of mud, bamboo, wood, straw and stones. Huts are made up of wood, bamboo, mud, straw and stones. What are bungalows? A bungalow is a house having a single story. A bungalow is a house having a single story. A bungalow can have many rooms and a small garden. A bungalow can have many rooms and a small garden. Next question. What do you understand by houseboats? What do you understand by houseboats? In Jammu and Kashmir, there are houses which float on water. That is called a houseboat. Okay, already you know. What do you understand the houseboat? That in that areas, that more rivers and then more rivers and lakes are there. So that only that people are mostly using the houseboat. In Jammu and Kashmir, there are houses which float on water. Mostly they are all float on water. So that is called a houseboat. Okay, இது தான் என்ன சொல்கிறோம்? Houseboat சொல்கிறோம். That houseboat is made up of wood. Okay, mostly the houseboats are made up of wood. Once again, what do you understand by houseboats? In Jammu and Kashmir, there are houses which float on water. In the regions, people mostly using this houseboat. They are mostly float on water. So that is called a houseboat. In Jammu and Kashmir, there are houses which float on water. அங்கே நிறைய ஹவுசஸ் வந்து தண்ணியில் தான் மிதந்துக்கிட்டு இருக்கோம். ஸோ தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அ ஹவுஸ் போட்ஸ். கேன் யூ கிளியர் திஸ் க்வெஸ்டின்? எஸ். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், Why do the houses in the mountains have sloping roofs? Why do the houses in the mountains have sloping roofs? Why? Because of in that mountain region area where it rains a lot, otherwise the snow, so that rainwater or snow easily slide down on the ground. So that only the people are built in the sloping roofs, slanting or sloping roofs. In mountain areas where it rains a lot, houses have slanting or sloping roofs. They allow rainwater or snow to slide down easily. So mountain regions la eppadi irukum adikadi mala peyum nariya pani mootama irukum so adala easy ah store aagi roof la illama easy ah slide down aagi keela poradhukaga that people are build this type of roof. In mountains areas where it rains a lot, houses have slanting roof, slanting or sloping roofs. They allow rainwater or snow. Okay, the slanting roof is allow rainwater or snow easily to slide down easily. So that only they are all built this type of roof. In mountain areas where it rains a lot, anga adikadi mala peyum romba winter time, that place is very cold. So mala nerathula romba mala irukum. So that only that people are built slanting or sloping roof. In mountain areas where it rains a lot, houses have slanting or sloping roofs. They allow rainwater or snow to slide down easily. Mele vandu store agama takkinu keela vilra maadhiri build panirukanga. So that type this type of roof is used to warm the house. Next one, where should we throw corpage? Where should we throw corpage? We should throw corpage in the dustbin. Where should we throw corpage? We should throw corpage only in the dustbin. Nama waste material enga da podanum? Dustbin la da podanum. Don't throw here and there. Okay, we should throw corpage in the dustbin. Dustbin la mattum da use panna corpage. Corpage means what? Waste material. So adla kondu dustbin la mattum da use podanum. Where should we throw corpage? We should throw corpage in the dustbin. Once again, what do you understand by houseboats? What do you understand by houseboats? Houseboats always float on water. Okay, houseboats are always float on water. In Jammu and Kashmir, in this region, people always float on the water. So that region people use the houseboats. In Jammu and Kashmir, there are houses which float on water. That is called houseboat. In Jammu and Kashmir, there are houses which float on water. That is called a houseboat. Why do the houses in the mountains have a sloping roof? Yeah, mountain region la sloping roofs. The people build a sloping roofs. So in mountain areas where it rains a lot, anga adikadi mala peyum cool winter time la bayangara snow irukum. So that region people build a slanting or a sloping roofs. In mountain areas where it rains a lot, houses have slanting or sloping roofs. They allow rainwater or snow to slide down easily. In mountain areas where it rains a lot, houses have slanting or sloping roofs. They allow rainwater or snow to slide down easily. Where should we throw corpage? We should throw corpage in the dustbin. Okay, we should throw corpage in the dustbin. Can you clear this question answers? Yes. Next, the detail answer. How to make the house clean? How to make the house clean? A house should be swept and mopped every day. Daily enna pannirukkanum? Veeda perikkirukkanum, kootirukkanum, thodachirukkanum mop pottu. A house should be swept and mopped every day. டெய்லி வீடை தொடச்சி வாரியல் வச்சு பெருக்கி தொடச்சிருக்கணும். த்ரோ கார்பேஜ் இன் டஸ்ட்பின். கார்பேஜ் வேஸ்ட் மெட்டீரியல் வி மஸ்ட் த்ரோ இன் தி டஸ்ட்பின். டஸ்ட்பின்ல தான் குப்பைகளை போடணும். த டஸ்ட்பின் ஷுட் ஆல்வேஸ் பி கவர்டு டு கீப் த ஃப்ளைஸ் ஆஃப். டஸ்ட்பின் எப்படி இருக்கணும்? கவர்ட் பண்ணியிருக்கணும். ஸோ அதனால ஓப்பனாக இருந்துச்சுன்னா என்ன செய்யும்? நிறைய மஸ்கிட்டோஸ் ஆர் ஃப்ளைஸ் ஆர் in the dustbin. So that only we are all using the dustbin is covered. The dustbin should always be covered to keep the flies off. டஸ்ட்பினை வந்து கவர் கவர் பண்ண டஸ்ட்பினை யூஸ் பண்ணோம்னா என்னது மஸ்கிட்டோஸ் ஃப்ளைஸ் எதுவும் வராமல் பார்த்துக்கலாம். வாஷ் யூட்டன்சில்ஸ் ஆஃப்டர் யூஸ் டு அவாய்ட் ஃப்ளைஸ் அண்ட் காக்ரோச்சஸ். நம்ம யூஸ் பண்ண வெசில்ஸ் பாத்திரங்களெல்லாம் என்ன பண்ணணும், உடனே வாஷ் பண்ணி க்ளீன் பண்ணிடணும். அதை வந்து ஒன் ஆர் டூ ஆர் த்ரீ டேஸ் யூ கெப்ட் இன் தி வாஷ் பேஷன் ஸோ தட் ஃப்ளைஸ் ஆர் மஸ்கிட்டோஸ் ஆர் காக்ரோச்சஸ் ஆர் இன்சைட் தி வாஷ் பேஷன். ஸோ யூ அவாய்ட் டோன்ட் do this like so that only wash utensils after used to avoid flies and cockroaches after use clean. okay, wash utensil after used to avoid flies and cockroaches. உடனே clean பண்ணிரணும். அது என்ன பண்ணக்கூடாது, அப்படி வைக்கவே போடவே கூடாது. grow plants near your houses. okay, நம்மளோட houses surrounding ல என்ன பண்ணணும், we grow more plants. so first one, a house should be swept and mopped every day. daily வீடை பெருக்கி துடைச்சிருக்கணும். throw garbage in dustbin. waste material garbage waste குப்பைகள் எல்லாம் எங்க தான் போடணும், டஸ்ட்பின்ல போட்டுருக்கணும். the dustbin should be covered. டஸ்ட்பின் எப்படி இருக்கணும், நல்லா கவர்ட் பண்ணி வச்சிருக்கணும். wash utensils after used to avoid. உடனே சாப்பிட்ட உடனே வாஷ் vessels எல்லாம் வாஷ் பண்ணி க்ளீன் பண்ணியிருக்கணும். plate cooking vessels everything clean, எல்லாத்தையும் க்ளீன் பண்ணி வாஷ் பண்ணி போட்டுறணும். இல்லைன்னா என்ன ஆகும், ஃப்ளைஸ் அண்ட் காக்ரோச்சஸ் ஈ கொசு எல்லாம் வந்து என்ன செய்யும், அதில் மொக்க ஆரம்பிச்சிடும். ஸோ ஆஃப்டர் யூஸ் யூ அவாய்ட் திட் ஃப்ளைஸ் அண்ட் காக்ரோச்சஸ். க்ரோ பிளான்ஸ் நியர் யுவர் ஹவுசஸ். என்ன பண்ணணும், நம்ம வீட்டை சுற்றி நிறைய மரம் செடி வளர்க்கணும். ஸோ க்ரோ பிளான்ஸ் நியர் யுவர் ஹவுஸ். ஒன்ஸ் அகைன், ஹவு டு மேக் த ஹவுஸ் கிளீன், ஹவுஸ் ஷுட் பி ஸ்வெப்ட் அண்ட் மாப் எவ்ரிடே. ஸ்வெப்ட்னா என்னது பெருக்கிறது, மாப்னா துடைக்கிறது போட்டு. த்ரோ கார்பேஜ் இன் டஸ்ட்பின். த டஸ்ட்பின் ஷுட் ஆல்வேஸ் பி கவர்ட் டு கீப் தி ஃப்ளைஸ் ஆஃப். வாஷ் உடன்சில்ஸ் ஆஃப்டர் யூஸ் டு அவாய்ட் ஃப்ளைஸ் அண்ட் காக்ரோச்சஸ். த்ரோ பிளான்ஸ் நியர் யுவர் ஹவுஸ். கேன் யூ கிளியர் திஸ் லெசன்? எஸ் டுடேஸ் ஹோம் அசைன்மெண்ட், லேர்ன் அண்ட் ரைட், ஃபில் இன் தி பிளாங்க்ஸ் இன் லெசன் த்ரீ. Can you clear this topic, ma? So what we heard in this topic, this previous classes we learned different types of houses. What are the different types of houses we have learned? That is a pakka house and the kacha house. That cement, brick, iron, steel, these materials are used to build a pakka houses. Wood, mud, bamboo, straw, stone, these materials are used to build a kacha houses. Okay, an apartment building, apartment bungalow, these are all an example of a pakka houses. And then hut is an example of a kacha houses. And then next what we learn, the different types of roofs also we have learned. Another one, that permanent and temporary houses also we have learned. What are the permanent house? That some type of houses fixed on the ground. So for example, bungalow, apartment, hut, this type of building are fixed to the ground. So this type of these are all the example of a permanent houses. Okay, and then some people are don't live in a particular time in the same place, so they are all moving, they keep moving here and there. So they are all live in the, they are all using caravans and then houseboats and then tent. Okay, so these are all the example of a temporary houses. Okay, so these type of houses, the some people using the temporary houses, tent, caravan and canvas. Okay, so permanent and temporary houses. Next one, different types of roofs also we have learned. What are the different types of roof? The roof is an important part of a house. And then there are three types of roofs already we have learned. What are the three types of roof? One is a flat roof. Okay, in which area people are used flat roof? That plains and dry regions. Okay, plains and dry region people build a flat roof because of that area very hot. So that flat roofs are keep cool in the inside the house. And then next one is a slanting or a sloping roof. Okay, in a mountain or hills region people are build a constructed in a sloping or slanting roof. Because of this type of roof, that rainwater or snow too easily slide down. So that only their people are build slanting or sloping roofs. The slanting or sloping roofs is helps to keep the house warm. And then next one, igloo. So some special houses also we have learned. What are the special houses? In a cold region, in a polar region, people are build a igloo. That igloo is made of ice blocks. Okay, so it's that igloo's is a roof is a round or arched roof. Okay, it's a roof is a round or arched roof. It helps to keep the house warm. The igloo is a round or arched roof. It helps to keep the house warm. And then another one special house. What is the special house? The stilt is one of the special house. Because of the where the stilts are made up of in the heavy rain regions. Okay, some areas lot of rain. So that time that regions peoples are built in a stilt houses. It's built in a higher from the ground. Ground la irundhu namu vayarama nalla bamboo bolts potu they are all built a stilt house. And then these people are living in heavy rainy region. People are living built in the stilt house. They are all live in this type of houses. Okay, and then next what we learn in this topic, clean home. How to keep our house clean. So these are all the step to keep our house clean. First one, house should be swept and mopped every day. Throw the garbage in dustbin. The dustbin should be covered. And then wash our utensils after use. And then grow plants near our houses. This is the way to keep our house clean. Okay, can you clear this topic, ma? I give some fill in the blanks and answer the following. Okay, you have learned today's homework. Learn and write, fill in the blanks in lesson 3. Thank you.